Let's get more now on that troubling foot and mouth outbreak, with fragments now detected in products on the shelf of a Melbourne supermarket. And I'm joined by Australia's Chief Veterinary Officer, Mark Shipp, and Alex's mum, Anne, who's a farmer in Coonamble, New South Wales. Nice to see you both this morning. Mark, I'm going to start with you, if you don't mind, because I think there's a lot of confusion around foot and mouth disease. Can you explain simply what it is and how devastating it will be if it hits our shores?
So foot and mouth disease is a highly contagious viral disease of cattle, sheep, goats and pigs. It's spread through food, through the air and through contact between animals. And if it causes blisters around the nose and the feet of animals so that they are unable to walk and unable to feed themselves easily, if it were to arrive in Australia, we would lose the majority of our market access for animal products and animals themselves. So all of the beef, lamb, wool, dairy products that we export, and we export 70% of our production here in Australia, would not be able to be exported. So it would have a devastating impact. It's been estimated that the consequences would be in the order of $80 billion over 10 years.
Gee, I mean, that is so hard to get your head around that figure. And so then, just hearing yesterday the discovery of fragments of this disease in a Melbourne supermarket, I think when we first heard it, we were all quite alarmed. But how concerning is that? Because we're talking about packaged food here.
The concern is that the most common way for foot and mouth disease to enter a country is through food products and feeding of discarded food to pigs in particular. So it's very important that we look at all the possible avenues of foot and mouth disease into Australia, and that's why we've been looking at the footwear of travellers coming back from Indonesia. But we're also have an ongoing program of looking at food coming into Australia. That's why we ask people to declare food when they come into Australia, and we undertake these types of surveys in supermarkets to see if food is compliant with Australia's biosecurity requirements.
I mean, this is where it's scary, right, that how easy it is to possibly to get in, especially when we know it is on our doorstep. It's now in Bali. How confident are you that we can keep it out?
Quite confident. We know that many countries in our region have foot and mouth disease, and we've been dealing with that risk for decades now on a daily basis at Australian airports and through the mail system and through our cargo system. We've got biosecurity officers that are managing this risk on a daily basis. We knew that foot and mouth disease, once it entered Indonesia, would get into Bali and spread further, and we ramped up our biosecurity efforts in response to that. So we're seeing things like the foot mats that have been placed in airports at the moment, the additional use of x-rays and detector dogs, the increased interventions by biosecurity officers at airports, and this type of surveillance work that we undertake behind the border at retail outlets and supermarkets.
OK, I want to go to Anne now. Anne, obviously, you're a farmer, you're in country New South Wales, you have cattle. We've been talking to Alex a bit about this over the past couple of weeks. How nervous are you?
We're all very, very worried. Yes, it would have a terrible, terrible impact on the farming situation with the cattle. Terrible.
So say it does get in, worst case scenario, what will happen?
Well, the affected cattle would all have to be slaughtered, and I would think in a huge radius of wherever the cattle are that are contaminated, that there'd be a lot of slaughtered cattle, just like they've had to do in other countries.
So do you feel at the moment that enough is being done to keep it out?
Well, they say they're doing it, but I'm hearing stories from people that they're actually asking for foot baths and a wash of their shoes as they come into the country in various ports, and they're saying, no, no, we're not doing that. So apparently it's not happening as much as they say it is, but it just needs to be. Shoes need to be either left there, thrown in the bin, or there has to be washing of shoes, etc., on entering back into Australia.
All right. Well, look, Anne and Mark, appreciate both of you joining us this morning. I think that this is a debate and conversation we'll be having a lot over the coming days and weeks. Thanks for your time. Carl.
Makes a lot of sense, Anne.